Benny, thank you so much for letting me know in over here. Thank you for the invitation. I don't know where to start. So this album. So I work in Infosys. I'm a project manager there, and that's my only claim to fame in this world apart from this music album. So for me, music has always been a passion. I've not learned music. I'm not as fortunate as you guys to have master teachers and studying music, so to speak. I kind of learned it on my own, right from childhood. Exposed to a lot of music, Turkish, Greek, Arabic, flamenco, Indian classical, of course. So I think that's taught me whatever I know about music. And I took a break earlier this year from work for a period of 4 months, and I set about making this album full time. So I used to spend at least 16 to 17 hours in my studio. I've got a studio at home. It's called Blank Point Studios. And there's a story behind it, I'll tell you about that. But yeah, this album is completely instrumental. And I call it voiceless emoting. When you put in lyrics to a song, obviously you as a listener are connected to those thoughts. Putting instrumental music, you're free to think whatever you want to. And I tend to think quiet. So that's the concept behind the album. And I consider myself to be extremely blessed to actually learn from music and give back to music. Humbling experience, extremely blessed. And to have wonderful people like Chaturveda, and it's absolute bliss that I'm going through in my life. I don't know where to start. Do we play the music now? Or, yeah, okay, cool. So that's about it. I'll keep it short. If you're curious on what Think Quiet means, now, all of us know we have five elements that we all work under, like air, water, fire, earth, and ether. This album is about ether. So what got me thinking in the month of April when I went on the break was, we all know how to represent earth, water, fire, and probably air as well, because we breathe it. But what do we do for ether if I have to, you know, sketch it, or if I have to paint it, if I have to draw it? So that got me into this whole concept. And ether so beautifully arrived at the concept for me for the whole album. Ether can only be sensed by your ear, which means everything that's music is ether. Everything that we speak, all the noises that we hear around, though a lot of us hate noise, I just absolutely love it. I love every traffic jam in Bangalore. I love to be part of that chaos, the noise, because everything you're blessed to hear, it's absolute blessing. So that's the concept behind the word. In fact, four of the songs towards the end. So the album has 12 songs, around 54 minutes of playtime. And the last four songs are dedicated to the concept of void, where you'll hear the songs now. It's completely tailored with sound effects. The music plays a very, very minuscule role in those songs. I want people to hear the sound effects more than the music. So you get used to the noise that we are also part of. So that's about the album Think Void. And I've been blessed to have some wonderful collaborations on this album. Starting with Keith Peters, who's been the bass guitarist for A.R. Rahman. So he came to my studios and he performed on two songs. Baiju Dharmajan performs on this album. He's a Carnatic rock guitarist. Finally, Prakash Santake, who's a Hindustani classical slide guitarist. And I had a unique collaboration with a guy called Adriano Fernandez, Spanish guy, who plays the music saw. So the hacksaw blades that you would have seen, or the saw cutters that you see, he uses that to play music. So I collaborated, and for me, as I said, sound is everything. All of these are sounds. So the album has all of this. We'll just play it and probably look to your feedback, and hopefully you enjoy it. Thank you so much.